There we go.
The warm-up is ending.
Yeah, the warm-up is ending. So they said 2-minute warm-up. That is what it is. And the players just have to go with it, I guess.
So the top 12, that is, they have 26 seconds between them.
All right.
So safe to say that this map, most players probably did not put any serious effort into playing it.
Yeah.
Which kind of makes sense, because what are you going to do? It's a 7-minute map.
Yeah,
so anyway,
true.
The multi-stream is live.
There we go.
Please take a look at it. And hopefully that's going to be all entertaining as we see Razorlight now lead the field through the first couple of corners. And I guess, you know, for the first minute or so, we're just going to try to keep an eye on what is happening across the field. And if maybe some players we did not expect to fall behind have actually lost a touch. This is a 7-minute map. Difficult, obviously, to say that there won't be a comeback, but when you kind of lose the flow early on, it's very difficult to regain it. And Spider, for instance, falling behind quite a lot, he didn't crash, he just completely lost his speed. Presumably, he didn't even have a chance to play this map before, so just be
very
short, seeing it for the first
window.
Time.
Yeah. Also interesting, I think, for spectators on the stream to watch on the left-hand side of the screen. We have a very nice overview of the live CPs, so that is good.
You can see, obviously, for yourself. I see your messages in chat, I just can't really respond while I'm casting, but I'll take a look at that a bit later. Anyway, while we're on the topic of that, Dopamine, I'm not sure if this top one is actually, you know, relevant, but so far, at 7 seconds behind the Daddy One time, which is also set by him, so I'm not sure if they're just driving slowly and safely, or if there's something broken about that CP timing.
All right.
I guess we'll see for ourselves, as by now I think the lead is kind of profiled. Dopamine almost a second, the advantage over Devil in second place. Stake and Nez following Strem and Razorlight. Really behind them, Mew and Spider, the first high profile people.
Yeah.
Sort of fall behind severely, but as I can tell, Mew is the only one that actually finished a lap, and it's not been particularly fast. Spider probably driving blind. Ekstrom now on the offensive against Devil, taking second place. Both places regained in a very short period of time. So the track is multi-lap, so that's the reason why we're behind Daddy One, because it wraps around the public server where they presumably trained it. Anyway, Nez now falling slightly behind. Razorlight probably poised to overtake him soon. Dopamine's lead continues to increase. He's actually made up time compared to his own Daddy One, so he's on an absolute banger of a lap.
All right, so Dopa
as
doing
we
well.
Are
now
coasting. Coasting for about a third of the lap.
Yeah.
Taking third place. Ekstrom falling to fourth, not too far behind. Nez continues dropping positions as now he could potentially be overtaken by Miracco. Mew, Yuki, Spider, Dev, and Disrenoob gone essentially from the running. Luxie in 12th place, the only person I think is still sort of keeping up with the main group, if you will. Top 5 sort of profiles itself. Dopamine, Ekstrom, Devil, Razorlight, and Stake. All Division 1 players be expected. Bellman, the first Division 2 player, in 7th place, 4 seconds. Behind the lead.
All right.
This is, as I mean, if I understand it correctly, this is just a one lap map. Maybe it's 2 or 3 laps. Don't think they can do more than that if they want to play 5 maps in the time remaining for endurance. Dopamine continues to be on the march. He's now 3 seconds ahead of second place and continuously making up time to Daddy One. Obviously, it's not very realistic considering that that was set on a flying lap, but so far he's absolutely been dominating everyone on the map. Ekstrom now almost 4 seconds behind. Devil as well. Stake and Razorlight stable in 4th and 5th. Sure, if he actually played it enough to memorize the whole map, it feels like he's driving basically without any special reservation. He's just absolutely smashing it with the normal pace.
Yeah, I have to say it looks pretty clear though. Like the signs are of course there, which has to be
in
the map
like
this.
It's fairly clear, but if you are driving it for the first time, you will forget and eventually miss, and you can't really drive it quickly by sight alone, as Dopamine continues to make up time to his own personal best. So if this were a flying lap, he would now almost be a second and a half ahead of Daddy One. On track now for a sub 7:25 time. Nez in sixth place now, keeping up with Racer Light and Stake. Ekstrem about a second ahead of Devil.
Pretty close there for the 4, 5, 6 fight.
So good, and now, only six players in the main group. The others have all made some kind of mistake and now fell one or multiple checkpoints behind, as we are now approaching the two-thirds mark of this absolutely massive track. As players that haven't played it before are lost, it is not doable to navigate this map without even trying it before, so... That is, I suppose, interesting, but not entirely unexpected, and I do think a 7-minute map is a bit excessive.
Yeah.
Considering it is only Wednesday,
players
that, have a normal working life probably barely had any time to look at it, if any at all, so...
Very true,
Sympathizing with Spider here, because normally you would expect it to be a kind of map that you can probably learn in the first couple of laps and come out with a passable time, but it's just not doable whatsoever. Ekstrem actually keeping his deficit to Dopamine pretty constant at just under 4 seconds, and Dopamine continues making up time to his personal best. Would now be almost 3 seconds ahead if it were a flying lap, so doing very well for himself, and now Stake and Racerlight falling further and further behind, unable to keep up. Nez now even taking fifth place from Racerlight to the field, quite far behind. To the final minute now, or at least what should be the final minute, looks like Dopamine is still driving without absolutely any regard for safety.
Cool. He is going for it.
Yeah, he is absolutely going for it. He probably realizes himself that he's actually putting in what would be a Daddy One lap under flying conditions. Some margin. It would have been a 7:16 this way. We're looking at about 7:23, 7:24. Very well, and extending the advantage over Ekstrem, who is now almost 5 seconds behind. Nez falls behind Racerlight, rest of the field. Indeterminate, as they're either lost or so far behind, they are not competitive whatsoever. Coming now into the final corners, the end of this 7-minute wonder. Dopamine has made up another second and a half just in the past segment, and he finishes slap in a 7:22.5 on a first lap. So that was 4 seconds faster than Denny One.
Wow.
Under flying conditions. Now almost 5 seconds the advantage to the second best player in Ekstrem. As we head into lap two, not sure of how many laps it is, but...
Should be two then, pretty sure.
It should be two. 15 minutes are just about enough.
Yeah.
As we see then, see if he can actually repeat this previous lap with any sort of consistency. Ekstrem, the one keeping up at 5 seconds. Now Racerlight in fifth place, almost 10 full seconds behind Dopamine.
Ooh. Ekstrem is doing impressive here, I think.
Ekstrem is doing remarkably well for himself. Devil keeping up as well. Nez, I think, punching above his weight in sixth place, 10 seconds behind. Rest of the field seems to have crashed early on, so are no longer in any sort of competition. Mew still in 13th place, thanks to several mistakes. Spider lost, and KWS is driving, I guess, just to warm up, because he's now one lap late to the start of the race.
Yeah.
Obviously, Ekstrem already very well known for his endurance proficiency as part of the virtual endurance event and also the NRL endurance event. And I think
true.
A lot of Spider as well was probably expecting his experience from driving NRL endurance cups to help him, but a map like this, which cannot be learned visually, just no way for you to do that kind of thing. So, unexpectedly, he fell very, very far behind. Dopamine now in the blue, 0.3 of a second ahead of his flying lap personal best, but as a reminder, over the course of the previous lap, he built up a 4-second advantage to it, so that time is eminently beatable. To be seen, however, if he can actually continue without making a single mistake. So far, it's been a perfectly clean run on a 7-minute lap from Dopamine. The only player that has been clean and consistent, but the only one that's able to maintain this kind of elite pace at the same time. Israelite, however, does manage. So the top five sort of stabilized and they're all driving at the same pace now. So
yeah,
the lead at about 5 to 6 seconds and 11 seconds to fifth place has stayed more or less consistent. Miracle also stabilizes in seventh place at about 20 seconds away. Meanwhile, though, below that, it's not going particularly well for anyone. They now almost approach the half a minute mark or more behind. Pomme dropping a bit of pace compared to his Flying Lab personal best, and Ekstrom also keeping it quite stable at 5.6 seconds behind. Still, Ekstrom not actually making up any time.
Yeah, that
he
is.
He would
insane.
Require a mistake from Dopamine to take first place, which doesn't seem to be forthcoming with the way he's driving. His Danish duo partner in Devil, however, settling for third place, not able to make a dent in Ekstrom's lead, keeping about 1 second behind him.
Yeah, Ekstrom looking good. Not giving anything away to Devil, indeed.
Dopamine now increasing his pace, almost coming to 1 full second ahead of his Flying Lab personal best. Now at 8 tenths and increasing his lead to Ekstrom to 6 full seconds. Absolutely unstoppable and unrivaled so far on map number one. As he cruises slowly further and further ahead from the field, jumping down into that banked corner, perfect landing.
What a jump.
Doesn't let it get to him. That is quite difficult to land. It looks like you have to judge your speed perfectly, and he does just that. Getting now into that loop turn and some airtime, coasting the 1 second mark ahead of his Flying Lab personal best, and now almost 7 seconds ahead of Ekstrom, so the pace has absolutely increased over the past 2 to 3 minutes.
There we go.
Now over halfway through the second lap for him. Stake stabilizing at 10 seconds behind, now catching up to Devil. Devil falling to 2 seconds behind Ekstrom. So far, so good. Rocco falling back to 25 seconds behind in 7th place, so consistency alone not nearly enough to keep up. It is pure pace that is setting the advantage in the top 5. Dopamine now cruises closer and closer to the 2 second margin ahead of his Flying Lab personal best.
Wow.
As a reminder, it was 4 seconds by the end of the previous lap, and he now coasts 2 second mark, so he has about 2.5 minutes to finish this lap off in style.
Wow, another half
second.
Now
2.4 seconds ahead of it.
Wow.
3 seconds almost.
Holy
so this
moly.
Segment was not particularly strong on his previous personal best. Absolutely marching towards the lead. That being said, Ekstrom keeping it at 7 seconds while Devil falls behind to 10.8 seconds. So.
Yeah, impressive by Ekstrom. Still impressive.
3.3 seconds now. Looking to maintain an absolutely blistering pace, yet to set a single foot wrong in almost 12 and a half, 13 minutes, excuse me, of playing this 7 minute long map with almost no visual cues.
Wow.
Cannot set a foot wrong as he starts to slowly approach the end of the lap, maintaining about 3.6 seconds to the personal best. No loop bug for him this time. Racerlite in fifth place, now 15 seconds behind.
And that is
Racerlite. That is Racerlite we're talking about.
Yeah.
Who is himself incredibly strong as an endurance player.
Exactly.
Approaching now the end of the lap, not much time remaining. See this one through. Does lose a bit of time finally on the split, but doesn't care much about that. He's still 3.3 seconds behind. Excuse me, ahead. His own best time, and of course, of everyone else. Increases his lead to Ekstrom to almost 8 seconds now. The approaches, which should be the end of the second, and I think final lap to the final flat corners. Not much more remaining. I think he did release a bit there. Dropped a bit of pace. Not that he cares with the pace he's currently absolutely flying at.
What a monstrous run are we watching?
Well, it is, honestly, because it's kind of hard to put anyone else in a frame of reference. There aren't that many battles actually happening for any positions on field right now. It's a pretty solitary affair, so might as well keep an eye on the man currently running the field. 4.2 seconds ahead of personal best. This is absolutely out this world. 4.7 seconds. You make it five by the time he ends. What is he doing?
There we go.
And yes, that is the end of it all. Yeah. In 4.95 seconds ahead of his personal best, 7:14.24 to end it in 14 minutes and 36 seconds. Ekstrom in second place, 9
Devo
seconds
actually
behind, 14:45. Devo losing the third place, the last podium spot taken by Stake. Finishes the lap in a 7:20.20 to take overall third. Nez, the last person to finish under 15 minutes, in a sixth place, 20 seconds behind Dopamine.
Wow.
Ekstrom also setting a sub 7:20 time in 7:18.46. Miracu reaches the finish in seventh place. Bellman, I think, about to take a 15:14, almost 40 seconds behind first place.
Insane.
Plenty of time for everyone to finish, but I don't think they might like the times they're doing, as we see players like Mew struggling with the map itself, let alone driving it quickly. Even ninth place. Luxy about to take 10th. Almost a full minute behind first place for the top 10. Same
a minute
about.
Behind 11th, and Lucky finished as well in 12th place. All right, Hugo now in as well, and here is Mew.
Yep, arriving in an inglorious 14th place finish, plainly struggling with the map itself on top of his pace. And Yuki also in the 15th place. Think not exactly what he might have hoped for. Lucky shot, seeing a bit of discontent, and obviously I think this was the first time in basically the history of NASCAR that there was an actual poll of whether this map should be played or not.
Yeah.
There was serious consideration on whether this map should even be played, considering lag and considering obviously the fact that it is impossible to memorize to any significant degree.
Actually, Miracle with his frames that he got in seventh place, that is actually still pretty impressive. You see the people he finishes in front of.
He has to do well, and obviously a lot of players who chose to play on Wednesday are completely untrained, and on this kind of map, being untrained is simply not possible. You cannot drive this map just, you know, by sight reading the corners. I don't think there will be any more finishes, so I guess the players can take a 2.5 minute
going.
Break to rest their hands.
Yeah.
It's still Tuesday. That's even worse. Forgive me. I sometimes lose my frame of reference.
All right.
Is genuinely confusing why Tuesday of all times was picked. Picked, and I suppose it had to be because of some sort of scheduling difficulties, because frankly I'm not sure that a lot of players were ready to drive this kind of thing. It's just not really
I mean, especially
not really
for endurance,
realistically doable. Endurance is all about endurance in itself has interesting dynamics compared to team mode and rounds mode, because having to drive a map consistently for 20 laps just leads to completely different lines taken, and also to a completely different mental state and an approach to risking than rounds mode does itself. So it should be sort of, I'm not sure that making the map as challenging as this was necessarily the best move. But in the end, what's done is done, and the players will not have a chance to replay this map again, which means that for a lot of players, they might actually be in for a really bad time if a lower division player actually prepares the map and finishes it without crashing. That being said, that's
there
the end
go.
Of map number one.
Yeah.
And we are into a stake map, a flat map.
All right.
Be, I think, much more palatable for almost every player, and should be something that probably lead to some closer competition, because obviously Ekstrom, with his skill and with his endurance ability, only able to finish 9 seconds behind Dopamine.
That is insane indeed. Yeah.
Which, even over 15 minutes, that is a lot, so.
Yeah.
Yet to be, to see some real competition here. And, I guess this is another decent time to link the multi-stream.
Very good. Yeah. check it out, guys.
You can watch the POV of a single player. Well, you also get some general coverage from Rayma. So, looking at this map, yeah, so nothing to be, I think, specifically mentioned here. This is about as simple of a flat map as you can possibly have, and I don't think anything about it should be strange to the players. Even if you did, show up completely untrained, I think for most players they'll be able to manage a decent time.
Yeah.
Especially since they'll be playing about, I don't know, I expect about 20 laps of this map, or maybe 15, depending on how long it actually is. And it should be a much more closely contested affair as well, because I don't believe that Dopamine is good enough to take about 9 seconds out of all the other flat map players
on the
server at this moment.
All right. So, there we go. That was a very short lap. That was already finished there. Warming up is also finished. So that was actually pretty short. And it seems like we're ready to go for it here.
So as far as I see, this map is one of the untrained ones, as somebody mentioned that they do not actually know.
Okay.
But they haven't seen the map before. That being said, I don't think that should be a problem. This really is super intuitive to drive for most players. So I suppose that, I don't know, for this particular map, since we talked so much about Dopamine on the first one, I'd like to actually focus on his Danish counterpart in Devil and see if kind of performance he's going to put out, and maybe see what happens in the first couple of laps, which players maybe show up and which players don't. And obviously, since this is Stake's own map, hoping to see a good result out of him on this one as well, because he did quite well for himself on that first map.
Yes.
Finishing in third place after sniping Devil almost at the finish line after a 14-minute run, very closely matched with him. Number one, it is person you expect in the lead, but this time Spider and Mew able to keep up decently well. Third and fourth place as Devil just some overtakes into them. This time we have a lot of players keeping it much closer, and hopefully this is exactly the way it's going to stay for the foreseeable future.
That would be very nice indeed. Keeping it close, always very good.
Extreme now dropping a few positions with a slightly subpar lead. Fastest lap of the race, I think, now going to...
Little crash by Extreme there. So he has fallen back.
Dopamine still with the fastest lap in 31.97. The rest of the players seem to have set times around the 32 mark. Still, he is no more than a second ahead of Spider and Devil. Rest of the players falling slightly further behind. Stake, a respectable fourth position, as it seems that players have made their first mistakes. Devil does as well. Small slide out is going to cost him about a full second and a half and allow Stake to compete for the third position. Fastest lap of the race again set by Dopamine in a 31.89, but Spider doing well for himself in a 32.07. For Spider as well, we saw a very impressive performance in the final map of last week as well, where he combined with Dopamine to put in a super carry performance that saved the team game of that particular match, as Devil had underwhelming performance on the flat map. One person, however, who is not having an underwhelming performance is Yuki, whose talent on flat maps is well known, and he's now capping it off a very respectable fourth place currently, about 2 seconds behind the lead. Spider, with a mistake, falling slightly further behind now.
Oh, and Yuki touches the wall as well, so he will be overtaken by Stiko Racer.
To be fair, he is quite talented, but he does have to risk, I think, a fair bit to maintain this elite level pace.
Yeah,
other players may be able to do it in a slightly safer way.
Yeah.
With perhaps a bit less stress in the whole affair as well. Now, Spider, oh no, that's a big mistake by Devil. That's going to set him back multiple seconds, risked it a bit. He's going to be falling all the way below to 15th place, so 12 positions lost in the span of a single mistake. He's not going to like that at all. Now, Stake inherits the third place, doing very well on his own map, and Razorlight very close behind him, so the FUTS duo maintaining that sort of top 3 to top 5 position from map 1.
All right.
Slightly behind the Elite, and unfortunately, it doesn't seem again that anyone is willing or able to contest Dopamine in his consistency. While some players have set laps which are roughly competitive with his fastest, none of them are able to drive it in a consistent way. Dopamine has been putting in multiple 31.8 times, and the consistent pace of Stake and Racialite is almost half a second behind per lap. So even on a simple map, Mappa shows a pure difference in skill. This is an untrained map, obviously. So it's not that practice makes perfect. He is just that much better. Everyone else at maintaining elite level pace on a consistent basis. I think that is exactly what makes him so fearsome and what makes top NASCAR players in the first place. Mm-hmm. They are able to quickly get a grasp of every particular map, and that they are quickly able to maximize their performance on any given map.
Very true. We see Dopa fully utilizing that here, almost 3 seconds in front of Spider already, who himself is actually doing very well here, maintaining that second place, which is important for him on the total ranking, I think, after his performance on, of course, the first map that we saw.
Lucky Shot, Yuki, and Devil are doing very well for themselves. The FKX trio in positions 5, 6, and 7 doing extremely well for themselves. That being said, though, consistency has been known to be their enemy on occasion, so it remains to be seen whether they can actually fulfill that pace. On the disappointing end of the spectrum, we have Mew and Devil, 17th and 18th place with 12 seconds behind. They have to start making the comeback happen very quickly. That being said, though, simple map. Can learn it quickly, but mistakes backfire even more often than they normally do. Since this is such a simple map, it is very difficult to actually put a meaningful amount of time into everyone else on it.
Yeah, very true.
Even a great difference in skill is normally not enough to make up a very significant disadvantage. Ekstrom as well, in 18th place. And we see a massive crash, I think. Happens somewhere.
Division players, or Division 1 players falling back on this map, and indeed need to make up.
I think we lost Razorlight, actually. Falsby back to 15th place with a 12-second disadvantage, so multiple Division 1 players absolutely losing it, and now the FKX trio occupies positions 4 through 6, with Lucky Shot not that far behind Stakes, so trying to maybe fight for a podium position for the FKX.
Wow.
Very good result, and Spider has actually stopped Dopamine's advantage gain, so he's kept it stable at about 2.6 seconds, and set almost fastest lap time. So Mew and Spider 31.86 to Dopamine's 31.84, but it should be said they are still quite far behind, both of them, especially Mew, because unfortunately fastest lap doesn't matter if you are not fast enough consistently.
Yeah, very true, as we see a very interesting battle for third place. Lucky Shot overtaking Stiko as we speak, so that is very close.
And Lucky
there.
Shot keeps it very clean, so he's going to actually make up some time. And more importantly, he's actually also making up time to Spider. So Lucky Shot looking for an incredible finish as Belma now drops back, and Dev hasn't actually managed to make up any time. So it is Lucky Shot that cuts ahead of his FKX clanmates.
Yeah, great driving by him indeed. Devil still very far behind, though. We see more than 25 seconds.
He makes multiple mistakes. So Mew has started making the comeback happen. He has kept it stable at 12 seconds, and he's now in 11th place. But Devil has made multiple mistakes, which means, unfortunately, that his comeback attempt is going to be completely stopped. At this point, we're already on lap 13. I can't imagine there is all that much more time remaining. Probably looking at a 25 to 30 lap run if the duration of map 1 is anything to go by.
Yeah, so
Devil setting a 31.94, so again, a respectable time, but consistency is his downfall, and he will have to settle for a solitary 18th place finish, as I don't think almost any players are actually behind him. I think there's just 18 players on the server as we speak, and he's occupying last
that
place
last
at the moment.
As we see incredibly cruising into the top 10 now. So Mew stepping it
so
up.
So he's kept it at 12 seconds, and if he continues this kind of comeback, I think he can still make 6th to 7th place at best.
Yeah.
Remains to be seen what Focus and Lux are going to drive, because obviously they are also really strong flat map players, perhaps not at the elite level, but definitely not to be discounted. Lucky Shot now falling almost a second and a half behind Stake, not doing all that well for himself. Dopamine, I think, makes the first severe mistake in a while, dropping 0.6 of a second over the course of a lap, probably a release gone wrong, which allows Spider to sort of keep the time stable at about 3.6 seconds behind, but time is being made up, and Dopamine again cruising to a solitary lead, head and shoulders above everyone. Although everyone is able to manage his pace, they're not able to manage his consistency at all. Mew sets the new fastest lap of endurance at 31.77.
Wow.
His comeback is well and truly underway. He's the only person actually making up time to Dopamine as we speak, and he moves into 8th position.
All
King
right.
Good for a late comeback, and Focus is in 5th place, only 2.5 seconds behind Mew, so his comeback may well and truly be on the road, and I'm going to focus on him in particular. See if he can actually make the full comeback happen.
Is looking
Mew,
very impressive
obviously
indeed.
Not doing all that well on map 1 either, so he is in dire need of a comeback as well.
Yeah.
It's not like he's just fighting for cookie points here, he does need to make up some positions, and right now he's looking good
snack.
To overtake Bellman in some time, and Luxy has made a mistake ahead of him, so he might get 2 for the price of 1. Now looking to overtake Luxy, who's lost a lot of speed thanks to their mistake. That is 7th place for Mew now, and he's absolutely unstoppable.
Wow.
He's going much faster than Bellman. Assuming he doesn't make a mistake, he should be able to complete the overtake soon. Risks it a bit on the Rammstein, but keeps it together.
Oh!
Now he slides out.
Aye. So the first mistake by Mew in a long time, I think.
Spider
still close
keeping
there.
And Spider actually keeping it consistent. And Devil now is starting to set phenomenal lap times. 31.9, 31.8, but to no avail. He is still in 17th place and way too far back. Dev falling behind from 6th position to 16th with multiple mistakes. Looking good, and Mew has also now made multiple mistakes. He's lost 2 seconds over the course of this lap. Gave up the position back to Luxian Bellman, and now he might even be at risk of getting overtaken by Yuki and Nez, who are not that far behind him. Yet to be seen, however. Mew's pace on this is good, and I think this endurance might still go on for about 2-3 more minutes, couple more laps. He will try to perhaps seize this position from them. Not sure if it is the time that is summed up at the end or if it is the individual positions on the map, but either of them are well worth fighting for. Spider keeping it relatively competitive against Dopamine as Mew slides out again, so
yeah.
I think his comeback has finally come to an end.
Mm.
Looking stopped. Thought it said 30 laps here. I don't actually see a lap counter here in the HUD, but yes.
Yeah,
if it's 30 laps remaining, we've just
on
posted
the right.
A two-thirds.
Yeah.
Two-thirds mark?
Yeah, two-thirds. Yeah. Alright.
Spider has now stabilized it at 3.5 seconds. Might even try to make some sort of late map comeback, although I think Dopamine's lead is quite secure right now, as Lucky Shot risking everything, potentially try to secure third place as fourth is well and truly his.
All right, and Focus still in the top 5 here.
Focus still in the top 5, and now that Mew's comeback has been stopped, it is very unlikely that anyone's going to be able to stop him short of his own mistake. Has a very comfortable margin of error to Luxy. Almost 2.5 seconds then, keeping him in that position. I think Mew's run of form might have finally come to an end.
Yep.
Losing
an
eighth for a while, but still maintaining that 8th position, although Yuki behind him is now increasing his pace. Sets a 32 flat, 5th fastest lap we've seen.
Wow.
At least 5th fastest daily time. Obviously, we saw a lot of faster laps than that. In fact, we can actually keep track of the fastest laps above Mew in 1st place, and the 12th fastest lap was at 31.92, so
Mew,
top 5 players monopolizing.
Mew actually overtaking Bellman and Luxy again, so the fight for that 6th place is interesting.
Yeah, this time he has to make it stick, so no more,
yeah.
I think, time to make any severe mistakes if he wants a chance to catch up to Focus. I think that chance might have actually avoided him, because at this point, 3 seconds is a bit too much to make up in the remaining laps. I would just focus on defending the 6th position if I were Mew. Dopamine now setting a 31.81, that is the 2nd fastest lap we've seen thus far, and Day 2 as well. Increasing
right.
the lead to Spider and to the rest of the field as well. Lucky Shot does not seem to be making any ground compared to Stake.
Yeah, a bit in a stalemate there.
Everything freezes as Mew now starts building up a small pace advantage. The 2 players behind him. Being said, he's not free to make a mistake at this juncture, and he has to release a bit. As he just waltzed over a Rammstein, this might just be the opportunity Luxy and Bellman were waiting for. Yet to be seen if they can capitalize, though, is now Spider again making up a bit of time and reducing that lead again to about 3.3 seconds. Doing well for himself. Mew holding on to 6th place. Yuki now sets a 31.89 to get into the fastest laps. Not enough to cut the top 12 fastest laps driven, but enough for a comfortable 85.
All right, nicely done.
However,
Mew,
I think he just made a
mistake.
Or I think Yuki followed up that amazing lap with a mistake, so falls back to 10th place. Xtreme's long comeback only puts him in 11th. Devil's still in 15th place, continually losing time to what are presumably mistakes.
And Racer Light in 17th. Almost dead last, only in front of Mudala.
Dreadful flat map performance from them, and Mew is actually making up some time to focus. 2.2 seconds now, but I don't think he's got enough laps left to complete the full comeback. I think those mistakes after his long run of laps might have just been enough to prevent him from taking top 5. Being said, it is still a very respectable comeback from him as he made up almost 10 positions. Yeah. With the fastest lap, actually, we've seen outright also coming from him. Showing that flat map prowess he is renowned for.
Very impressive indeed.
Doing very well for himself, true. So Luxy now setting a decent lap time, but it is not enough to actually make a significant dent in Mew's time. As I say that though, Mew gives him the opening he needs. Nez is now falling behind, so it is just Mew and Luxy fighting for 6th place, and thanks to Mew's mistake, it is now a close battle. Devil drives a tied fastest lap, 82 in 31.77, but it is way too late for him to do anything significant. In this endurance run, Spider has kept it actually level with Dopamine, but he fell far behind early on and he never recovered. He's kept it at 3.5 seconds for almost the past 15 laps. He'll still have to settle for second because Dopamine doesn't make mistakes, or at least he doesn't make them often enough, but yeah. Spider comfortably second, as actually Focus is losing time to Mew, but Mew makes drifting. A mistake and looks he overtakes. Lucas has been continuously losing time to the players behind him, but not enough for it to matter. Mew made a severe mistake.
Oh no! Oh, how many places will that cost? End.
That's gonna cost him multiple places. He's now in 12th place, yes. Mistake unraveled and coming to nothing as the 13th place Hugo overtakes him now.
Oh no.
Yuki set Daddy free, 1/100 of a second behind the fastest lap outright driven, so Yuki absolutely driving the wheels off his car. Unfortunately, not good enough to get him more than 8th place as he has made several mistakes to follow up his amazing pace. Mew, the great loser of this map as he falls to 15th to come back to 6th place and then fall back to 13th place. To two severe mistakes which required a respawn, and Mew, who has 3 of the 12 fastest laps driven, have to settle for a 13th place finish because this is lap number 30.
Yes,
we
let's
are
see.
Out of time.
If Dopa will indeed finish here, he will pass the finish now.
He will get one position back from Hugo, and he will get a position from Yuki as well, and that is the end of it all. In 16 minutes, 6 seconds, and 36, Dopamine finishes. Spider has made up time to him in the final few laps, ending only 3.1 seconds behind, but still not enough to significantly challenge. Stake seals another second consecutive third place in a row with 9 seconds behind. Lucky Shot in an impressive 4th, 10 seconds behind. Focus secures that 5th place despite some pace disadvantage. Luxy in 6th, Ekstrom in 7th, Bellman in 8th, Miracle in 9th, and Nez in 10th place as Mew comes home to finish 11th. Unraveling to nothing thanks to some bugs. Racerlight in a disappointing 15th, Devil in a dreadful 16th. Not a good day to be a Division 1 player, well at least. Not most of the Division 1 players.
That's interesting to see indeed. Racer and Devil surprised. Yeah, indeed. They fell far, far behind.
Dopamine says it himself. You make a mistake on this map, it's kind of your fault because it's all avoidable. Ekstrem agrees with him, and I'm not sure if the Division 1 players that fell 15 seconds behind might be inclined to agree. But, well, that is the end of the second map. Dopamine, second consecutive first place. Spider definitely improving a lot from the first map.
Yeah, well
he
done.
Didn't have a chance to train. Stake in a second consecutive third place finish.
Yeah, and I think
quite well.
Lucky Shot and Focus really impressive here. And actually Luxy as well in the top 6, so nice performances by them, taking advantage of some mistakes of the Division 1 players. Well done. All right. So, already moving into the next map. No time to rabble around. Here we go. Temperly by Miracle. Do we know if this was trained or untrained?
I am not sure, but... So Nez says that the map is unknown to him, so... this is another untrained map. So, fairness, the last Miracle map we saw was really unorthodox. We saw it in week 4, I believe.
Yes.
It was another untrained map, which was just impossible for most players to get a grip of.
Mm.
Yet to be seen what's going to happen. However, this one does seem a lot more conventional. More conservative, so to say. And despite it being untrained, I do think most players will be able to get to grips with it. I do expect a lot of mistakes, since this is the kind of map which seems to me like it could provoke them. We see a lot of players in warm-up perhaps being caught a little bit off guard by the
chicane there.
Twists and turns of the map, but
something
about it to me seems very, you know, too undriveable. I think players will be able to get through it just fine. I do expect them to display at least some level of consistency. So yeah, looking at the lap, I think too out of the ordinary, it might not feel comfortable for some players, but it should be very drivable, which is exactly what they want from an untrained map.
All right.
Loop bugs could be worse.
Yeah.
But other than that, we'll see what it happens. And after this map, it's like a 5-minute break for the players to sort of rest their hands. Perhaps mentally reset, go drink some water. We'll take that break as well, obviously.
Yeah.
We're going to use it to bring you the latest news from 08 and other similar NASCAR news as
looking
we head into this one.
There we go.
We still have one map to cast before we take a significant break to hydrate.
Yeah, and the players are on the way. First,
we already see the first severe mistake. I'm not sure who that was.
That was Hugo.
Unfortunately, as we see you Nez and Dopamine taking the lead into the first couple of checkpoints, and we see also that there are a lot of turns which sort of control your speed very well. I don't think it's a particularly high speed map, which I think is quite useful in endurance because it just means that you are not likely to run into Rammsteins at high speed and you're not likely to be caught off guard by the timing.
Very true.
You can release and I think fall back into a very relaxed pace as long as you don't get hit by a loop bug, which is I think quite uncommon on upwards loops. Should be able to navigate the lap fairly well with no significant issues. Miracle now on his own map taking the free position. Dopamine again in the lead, but let's have competition. Oh no, Mew!
Mew! He just drifted out, has to reset, and he gives away almost every place he could give away. There we go. That lasts right now.
And Spider taking now the lead. It feels for the first time in any lap of any map.
Yes.
Someone has taken the lead from Doppelmine and it is Spider. And Spider, let me remind you, he did actually manage to be faster than Doppelmine for certain portions of map 2, but fell far behind early, so was unable to recover the lead. Fell behind by about 3 seconds, but he didn't make up almost a second at the very end. Respectable performance, as now we see a top 5-6 players within 0.2 seconds.
Yeah, super
very consistent
close.
And very well done. Racerlike leading us into lap 3, but Devil and Dopamine hot on his tails. Spider not to be forgotten.
Devil
now makes a mistake.
Yeah, he is gone. So one player eliminated from the close group that we have up front here. Very nice to see. Spider, Racer and Dopa now. Super close. Of course, a lot of laps to go, so they should keep it together.
And now only 6 players remaining within 1 second of the lead. It is Miracle, the mapper, Budala doing well for himself. And I think this is a kind of map style that might actually favor him. Obviously, might be better known to you as KWS from his stint in the SNC 2022, where he was, I think, a very vital part of PNE Orange and a big part of the success of this 4th place finish. Doing very well against a multitude of pure NASCAR teams as well.
Yeah.
Dala now keeping that 5th place as far as I can tell, Spider, that was risky. Racerlight dropping a bit of speed but staying alive crucially. Dala keeping that 5th place at about 0.8 seconds. He's the last person remaining within a second of Dopamine, and it might not be for long honestly because the pace the front of the pack is increasing. Racerlight and Dopamine sharing that he won in 51.23, but Belmont and Spider keeping up well. And KWS and Devil as well with competitive pace, however, still trying to make the comeback happen after a significant mistake on lap number 3, I believe it was. And Mew, since that mistake on lap 2, has actually made additional mistakes, so he's not merely last, he is last by a significant margin and 20 seconds off the lead already.
And Dopa with an incredible time there. underneath the 51, 50.9. First one to go under 50.
I don't know, makes a mistake on the drop or maybe bugs out. Not sure what it was. Dopamine with the first lap under 51 in a 50.92. Very well done by him indeed. But Racer Light and Budala, more importantly, keeping it, keeping him to only 1 second the advantage. So Budala with an amazing endurance performance so far.
He is doing very well indeed. Look at this. Super close behind Dopa still.
Oh, no. And now he finally slides out on the inner Rammstein, and it is now Miracle who inherits the third place. Unfortunately, Budala also had to eat the full respawn, so he will be dropping below the top 10 still. With the pace that he has demonstrated, still be something happening. Still be something to play for here if he can keep that pace following laps as well.
Let's see. Actually, Mu indeed in 18th and Lucky Shot in 15th place. So two of Division 1 again, a little bit further behind.
Lucky Shot now setting a competitive lap, so he might be on for a comeback in the later stages. That being said, the Deddies seem fairly competitive here. I do think that players just driving a safe and consistent pace like Focus could be in for another very high position finish.
Yeah.
As we see now, Stake may be struggling a bit by his standards, only in 7th place, 3.2 seconds off the pace. Racer Light, who was perhaps behind Stake on the previous maps, now taking a commanding advantage over his teammate. Stake inherits 6th place, barely overtaking Focus. Spider still competitive, 8th place with a 3.7 second disadvantage after his mistake. Racer Light now falling out of the 1 second barrier, so not going to be Dopamine again, marching out forward.
Yeah, he's
none of the players able
to
be competitive for long.
Yeah.
Now Racer Light, the disadvantage increases further and further. Now 1.5 seconds behind, and I don't think it's going to get any better. This is much longer, so I expect to see about, not sure, maybe 20 laps here? 22, 23, something along those lines.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure what the organizers chose.
Well, we'll see in the end. Focus with a nice overtake on Bellman.
Focus with a nice overtake indeed on Bellman. And this is Focus, I think, solidifying what has been a good performance so far. Perhaps exactly the best on map number one, but I think map number one was so outlandish you can't really take it against players if they do not manage to perform well on it. As now Miracle, Ekstrom, Focus, Stake, and Bellman form a group of 5 players very close, but Stake will drop out of it as he lands on a Rammstein and is forced to slow down significantly. I think Focus made a small mistake. This will allow Bellman to close in and overtake him now. Ooh. No, he won't, as he slides out. Shouldn't have spoken.
Little risk with the Ram
that
there.
Soon. Both of them actually risking quite a bit and falling slightly behind Ekstrom. Small curses affecting both players, but they still are heading in that group of players in the 4th, 5th, and 6th place battle. You setting some competitive lap times, but he's still dead last. Unable to make the comeback start. Devil, however, manages to return to 10th place after a quite significant error. And Spider, his comeback is stopped as he is not able to come into contact group here at the front. However, he sets a very competitive Deddy free time for fastest lap of endurance overall, 51.07. Spider might be approaching them soon, and we have this good battle from 3rd to 7th place and a couple of minutes to still see it resolve. Spider now increasing the speed. He's now on a masterful lap, 0.2 ahead of Deddy 1 on the first couple of checkpoints and far ahead of his personal best. So Spider has increased the pace drastically. 0.3 ahead of Deddy 1 now. Oh, that's not ideal. I think he might have released and lost a bit of pace there still. Doing well for himself and a 0.1 ahead of Deddy 1. More importantly, making significant gains to Bellman and significant gains to Focus as well. So far, so good. Racer Light falling behind to 2.5 seconds. Spider still maintaining the Deddy 1 pace, only dropping it now, but he's almost at the finish line. It's going to be an extremely impressive lap for him. And is Deddy 2, 50.96.
Wow, so third player to break the 51
now,
mark.
Now Bellman
there
closes in on Focus, and Focus closes in on Ekstrom. The fight will start heating up. Spider now also increasing his pace again with a very good start. He's going to overtake a Bellman right away. Now he's looking to make up further positions, but that was not exactly the ideal timing. Bellman will shortly regain his position as that was a bit of a suboptimal turn by Spider. Focus now going a bit further in the outside as he would have liked. This will allow Bellman to catch up with more speed in this particular corner. He might be able to carry it forward.
Let's see.
Sir Light falling super to almost close. 3 seconds behind as Miracle maintains that Spider is looking to overtake two players in one corner. Velma now drops away, but Focus gains more speed. It is Focus who keeps that fifth place. Devil sets the fastest lap of the race, 50.90.
Nice.
To begin his comeback from 10th position, Ekstrom in an incredibly competitive 51.12. 9 fastest lap so far. Rocco, 12 fastest lap so far in a Deddy 6 now. As the fight for 2nd to 6th place, I feel, is still quite open. 2 seconds separating 5 players. Yeah. Spider with a bit of an unorthodox line, but I don't think it's going to serve him very well. He actually drops some pace to Focus. Focus is now making up time to Ekstrom, so everything to play for. Stake now in 7th place is looking to join this group of players, but will need to step up his pace if he wishes to do so. Mew sets a Deddy 5 time, but he's only still in 16th place because of a very severe mistake. Spider now looking to complete the overtake.
Focus on the
will
nice
he manage
time.
To do it?
Yes.
But Focus is proving a very difficult nut to crack. Yeah, he's showing very consistent pace. Israelite in a 51.20. Focus in a 51.12.
Yeah.
Which is a shared 12 fastest lap. And Stake in a 51.14. Almost nothing separating these players. Spider risking it along with a Rumsen, but he will finally gain the position over Focus and now looks to attack Ekstrom. Spider's comeback has been nothing short of amazing.
Ooh,
Ekstrom now. The optimal line will allow Spider to attack, and Spider gains the position. 2 positions gained in the span of a couple of corners. Spider is on the warpath.
There we go, snacking away through the field. Might Miracle be next? The gap is
well, now
bit
in 8th
bigger.
Position, thanks to several mistakes, and Spider now on a time that matches the fastest lap so far. Incidentally, fastest lap thus far actually goes to Lucky Shot in a 50.70, and Budala in a 50.77. If they didn't make the mistakes, where could these players have potentially been? To know, as they are now 13th and 14th. Spider in a 50.85, 3rd fastest lap thus far. Incredible pace on display from Spider as he's looking to absolutely decimate
there
the field.
Go.
He manages to make it across Ekstrom. That was a risky landing, but he sticks it. However, Ekstrom, more stable on the landing, he will keep it close and then drop away.
And he is coming close to Miracle now as well. He's closing the gap. Look at
Spider
this.
Spider recovering multiple positions. It's still everything to play for. As a reminder, Focus, who is in 6th place, is still in vision distance of Spider overtaking Miracle there. And Racerlite is only 1 second up the field from Miracle and Spider. So anything still able to happen. Spider, I think, now has definitively gained 3rd position from Miracle.
Yeah.
On the absolute warpath. And actually, he's making up time to Dopamine as well. Not sure if he's going to have the time to complete it as we are approaching the end of Endurance, but Spider's comeback has been nothing short of amazing. It will, however, come to a temporary stop as Miracle regains control of 3rd place, heading now into this drop, which has been the downfall of so many players, and Spider regains the position.
Right.
I
it's a very
think
close
he regains
fight
the position,
here.
Actually.
Yeah. It's close. It's close. Ekstrom now joining that as well, so still super close, that group. Focus a little bit further behind. Still inside, indeed. Let's see how
Stake
this resolves.
Is going to try to take the fight to Focus. He has actually made up some time to him. Past couple of lacks. Oh no, Ekstrom risks and Ekstrom drops. Focus will inherit the position and Stake will also inherit the position. Ekstrom drops out of the battle. It is now Stakey that brings the rear of the field up, but I think Miracle and Spider are now in a group of their own, and Focus Stakey have to settle for being slightly further behind. Racerlite maintaining that 1 second advantage to the rest of the field, about 3 seconds behind Dopamine now. The comeback from Spider and Miracle has stopped, so Dopamine again gaining time. The rest of the field in solitary first place. He had to make a mistake all evening long. Even though this time Dopamine only has one of the fastest 12 laps.
Yeah, that is interesting.
Most of the other players that have set them have made severe mistakes.
And no Diddy won for him as well.
No Deddy 1, only Deddy 5 here, but he doesn't need to do it because he is driving. Actually, almost none of the players in the top 5 are setting some of the fastest laps.
And now Racerlite made a mistake. Small slide out to Spider, getting very close to him right now.
Only 0.2 of a second separate them, but Miracle is also there, don't forget. So if Racerlite makes a mistake, it might well be a 2-for-1. However, with 15 laps already done and Doppelmind now setting the 3rd fastest lap in a 50.84,
and there we go. That is actually
that was the
it.
End of it, actually.
Yeah, that is
15 laps only, so that was
earlier.
Shorter than the rest of the endurances.
Yeah.
And Dopamine, which is the unexpected finish line in 12:52.85, Racerlite keeping 2nd place from Spider by the skin of its teeth. Miracle, Mapper in 4th place. Focus again, very respectable 5th ahead of Stake.
Very nice.
Ekstrom's mistake sends him into 7th place. Devil's comeback stops at 8th place. Man 9th, Yuki 10th, Dev 11th, Discernoob 12th, Budala, despite having the 2nd and 4th fastest laps, only 13th. Lucky Shot, despite having the fastest overall lap, only 14th.
Mew just finishing.
Mew in 15th, Hugo in 16th, Luxi in 17th, Nez dead last.
Ay, ay, ay. What
speed
a map.
Does not equate consistency as we take a 5-minute break now to see what the players are going to do.
All right. So that was take very interesting map. Very interesting, I think, indeed. All right. Yeah, so small intermission.
Again, so Focus, Spider, and Dopamine repeating very good positions from the previous map. Stake keeping it very consistent. Ekstrom as well. Looking like the clear overall winners to me from the maps we've seen thus far.
All right. Mini break. Yeah, I will use that as well to go to the toilet very quickly. So see you in a second.
Map number 4. So while the players take 5-minute break, we are going to go to map number 4, which is Odd World by Lucky Shot. I'm not sure if this is a trained or untrained map as well. If it is untrained, that's going to be 3 untrained maps in a row, which I think some players are only starting to experience a bit of tilt here. So this is the 2nd trained map of the evening, and the final map, Liquid Ritual by Vamos Dakar, be the untrained map, and we can actually take a look at the people warming up. So 5-minute break was agreed, but it looks like some players do not actually want it to be a break. Yet to be seen what's going to happen, actually, is the warm-up is going to end in 30 seconds, and we're not sure what the players and admins are going to do about that. Map is looking, I would say, quite characteristic of Lucky Shot's mapping. It does seem quite drivable. Actually, no, what the hell is that? Is that a jump? What was that? Now I take it back. This is a bit weird for my tastes, honestly. But they did say it beforehand. So said actually on map number 2 that there would be a 5-minute break, and I'm not sure what's going to happen now. It was said, so not sure what the confusion between the players is. I'm not sure. Maybe he missed the message, because most players obviously play with interface off while they're warming up, so maybe they missed the message. So it is not live. They're taking a 5-minute break. And I'm going to use it as well to get a glass of water and try to rest my vocal cords a bit, because casting Endurance is goddamn difficult.
All right, So we are back here. And I see that me and Mr. Deft return at the exact same time. What a coincidence.
It is indeed, as they are taking a 5-minute break, so some players are just driving for the fun of it, I guess.
Yeah.
But we are not live, just in case there's any confusion about that.
Yeah, no, just waiting for the next map.
We can take a break to remind everyone that, you know, this TM 2020 campaign has an interesting map, which is basically NASCAR. Oh, wait.
Yes.
We, the NASCAR community, has 3 players in the top 4. 4 players in the top 15. God knows how many in the top 100. So Truo, I think, in 15th place. Bellman is also ranking quite highly. Reyma as well. Mm. Hovering around the top 25 mark with an incredible time. So if you have TM 2020, please go ahead, try and hunt it. Put some NASCAR community pride on the leaderboards, because we are competing with the pros.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
We are able to do some quite decent times. Like, didn't even apply the downhill trick yet, and that was enough for top 150. So,
yeah,
never know.
It is very nice, you know, to open the leaderboards and see your name amongst the likes of Alcon and Massa and people like that.
Obviously, yeah.
But we can do that.
Play TMGL, obviously.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
Yeah, give people a reminder of the fact that the NASCAR community exists and that we are better at it than anyone else. We're as good at it as the pros. So,
very good.
Feel free to try your hand at 08 and some NASCAR community pride as we wait for players to start the 4th map of Endurance. This is the 2nd train map, Odd
All right.
World by Lucky Shot. And it does have an interesting element for an Endurance map.
We
We're
saw it
see
here.
As the players drive.
Yeah.
Bit of a jump.
Yeah.
A very interesting one at that. And I imagine that more than a few players might have their runs ended by it.
We'll
see how that actually works in practice as I take a bit of a ache break.
All right.
There you go.
A little bit of hydration, of course, for the streamers at hand. Stop selling me TM 2020. It is, of course, whatever you want. You want to play it or not, but... it's good. Here we can see actually the jump by Spider. He just completed it. We see X-Ram just flying into the barriers. And as Dev just said, that will be a very interesting point to take note of indeed. And in an endurance map like this, going on for so long, it is a very risky element that can easily put you multiple seconds behind your competitors. Because of course we are driving with a lot of people here. From multiple divisions. So, yeah, people are actually fighting against each other, against the teammates. It's very interesting to see the individual battles here. And we'll see how the map will progress. I actually don't know how long we exactly have left, because there is no timer, but I assume...
We're going live in 30 seconds.
Ah, there we go. Bellman says it in chat, indeed. To 30 seconds, and then we'll be on the way with map number 4 out of 5, I believe. So one more after this one. And 20 laps, Focus says. So now we know. We take note. Good luck, drivers, indeed. All right.
Yeah, I imagine that jump is going to cost someone their life. Even though it seems quite doable, making a mistake once in 20 laps is entirely doable.
Yeah,
it might well happen.
For sure.
I think that's the element of the map will definitely cost the most players their runs, as I just like to remind you, if you're okay with it, of the multi-stream, a few extra views wouldn't hurt, obviously.
Keep popping in, guys.
Popping in, and you should actually have emotes on my channel soon as well, with any luck.
Let's go, caster curse
and stuff like that. Yeah, caster curse. I'm gonna get no one, but we'll see what happens. Obviously, after BFNL is over, we need the caster curse montage. And as a reminder, this is the final week of BFNL, so we're gonna have this, and we're gonna have the second group of endurance players that are gonna play these same exact maps, and we are done.
That will be it, not for today.
So 4th map. underway now. Odd World by Lucky Shot. I suppose we have to see who goes into the lead, because I think Lucky Shot on a map of his own might combine the pace which he has shown previously with some actual consistency. And, you know, I think that he might benefit very well from Mapper's advantage, obviously.
Yeah, this especially is a train map,
so it might be slightly reduced, but since it is Tuesday, I do think that not a lot of players had to train. And look at this, so already losing one player to the jump, it is Mew, unfortunately, who continues. It's been a pretty dreadful evening in terms of consistency, but another promising one in terms of pace, so honestly, that's just pretty standard for him at this point. Up number one, and we are blessed to have a leader other than Dopamine. It is Lucky Shot, the mapper himself, taking full advantage of his knowledge of the map and the fact he definitely had the chance to play it a bit more than the players with having mapped it. And Stake in third place, continuing what has been, I think, a very, very solid evening, which
very
should
see steady.
Him rank very highly.
Yeah.
Yeah, he had good pace. Oh no, Devil, that's a huge lockup. Rammstein Bug sends him away and packing, and again, he's forced to drive a map all the way from the back.
Yeah, comeback mode again.
Solitary 17th place.
Ay, ay, ay.
Mew fell further behind. Lucky Shot increasing his actually lead over Dopamine. This is unforeseen.
This is something else.
That we have another leader, and now Spider trying to make his way past Dopamine. So maybe now Dopamine can finally be taken down a peg, as multiple drivers are actually keeping up very close to him. Dev in an incredible fifth position. Only 0.9 seconds behind the lead.
Super close actually there with Dev Racer, Yuki as well. Miracle, of course, we are just underway. We have a
to
very
jump then, and everybody survives, but Spider has more speed. Oh, but Stake's follow-up corner is immaculate. Absolutely no room left for error. Spider will overtake him with a bit more speed, but that was so cleanly driven from Stake, who just keeps it razor clean.
Very nice. His buddy Racer
incredible indeed,
didn't really
Lucky
make
Shots.
It there.
Dopamine now finally stabilizing that gap to Lucky Shot, and about a similar gap to the rest of the field as Dev actually overtakes both of them to go into 13th place. Hugo's connection issues, I believe he's playing from Morocco, I think, and has connection issues, will unfortunately put him out of the race as this time is ruled invalid by the game because of connection issues. He will drop out. Though I don't believe he's actually had a super productive evening, but it is to be expected. I think that in terms of divisional play, he might be one of the lowest ranked players here.
Yeah.
He picked the time because it was more opportune. And we see Spider dropping away and Yuki now charging into the front of the pack. His Razor Light only in a solitary 8th place. You would expect him and Extra maybe to be near the top of the pack, but they are not. It is Dev and Yuki, the FKX teammates of Lucky Shot, actually bringing up lead, as Dopamine might not be able to resist him for much longer. The lead is being consistently chipped at little by little. Dev is trying to make his way to Dopamine to overtake him, and that is very respectable. Dev starting in Division 3, two consecutive wins, and then multiple very respectable performances in Division 2. Definitely a breakout name in BFNL 2022.
Again,
showing his great prowess here. Not managing to make up any time. Dopamine now drops him, but he's still in third place. And if he maintains this level of consistency, he may well stay in third place, because Stake doesn't seem to be in a particularly attacking mood. Just looking to conserve his pace and be consistent, hoping for others to make mistakes, as Dev makes just that.
Yeah.
And is now being overtaken for third place in Razorlight. Apparently he heard my disappointment, because he's now in fifth place and charging forward. Stake completes the overtake. Rhyme is perfect, as Razorlight is now also looking to grab that spot off Dev, as just squabbling with Miracle, not that far behind. Lucky Shot with the fastest lap in a 43.39, but Spider, I think, beating that with a 43.43.
Lucky Shot extending his lead as well to Dopa, 1.1 second now.
Dopa also extending his lead to the rest of the field, so clearly it's actually Lucky Shot who's in a level of his own, rather than, you know, Dopamine having an off day, because Dopamine is still putting a huge advantage into everyone else.
Yeah.
On pure merit, it is only Lucky Shot, the mapper himself, able to unlock its secrets better than Dopamine can. is trained, but that's, you know, the big quotation marks around that, considering it is only Tuesday. Not a whole lot of time for the players to develop some kind of strategy for driving this map with consistency, as Dopamine now begins chipping into the lead and breaking further and further away from Stake in third place. That is to be expected. Stake not driving aggressively, not driving to maximize his potential pace. He's doing the smart thing which has brought him 2 second place finishes in Division 1. Generally, I think, being a wonderful resurgence for a player that we've missed in competitive NASCAR for way too long.
Yeah.
We've missed the FOTS tag, and we've missed him in particular. He's definitely showed why he is playing some must-watch NASCAR right now. Dev, finally, with a significant mistake, will drop out several positions, and Racerlite inherits fourth place. So, top 5 positions for the FOTS boys. Doing well for themselves, but nothing world-breaking. Neither of them the top 12 fastest lap.
No, but once again, super consistent out of them. We've seen that, I think, all night
long. Indeed, and finally, Pamine gets into the rhythm, and Lucky Shot's lead is starting to evaporate at the front. Going to tune into Dopamine now as he hunts down that first place finish, which he feels has eluded him. Dopamine also setting a top 3 fastest time in a 43.45. Not sure why the server says it's the best lap. It is not. It is almost the best lap, only 200ths of a second separating the two. Well, only in 14th place, the comeback has not started very well. Spider dropping from 2nd to 3rd place to only 5.9 seconds behind. Xtrem maintaining 7th place, but nothing special for him. As Dev is looking to resist Xtrem, not sure if he'll be able to for long. Some of that inexperience showing despite a stellar start. Right now, all eyes are at the front of the pack. Dopamine breaking away from Stake, Racerlite, and Dev. Inching ever closer towards Lucky Shot, looking to erode his lead, looking to secure first place despite Lucky Shot having the mapper's advantage. Lucky Shot might say it's a map diff and Dopamine fix it should be a skill diff instead, as it is now 7/10 of a second only separating these two players. Thing now, finishing actually, lap 10, with 7.5 minutes done, you are you've just crested actually. First half, it is a 20 lap race.
Yeah. Just on 50% now, as they will almost lap overtake Mew here for one lap. Yeah. Wow.
A dreadful race from Mew. Being lapped is honestly quite humiliating, I think, for a fellow Division 1 player, obviously.
Yeah.
Who is well aware, obviously, that, you know, he can match them. But what's happening for him today, he's had some good pace, and he has the 11th fastest lap, daily free time. It hasn't helped him out.
Yeah. But
it is to no avail as Lucky Shot laps him. However, Dopamine keeps inching ever closer to Lucky Shot, eroding his lead little bit by little bit.
Only
6/10 of a second, as there are 9 laps remaining in this race, and you would be hard pressed to think that a player of Dopamine's caliber couldn't do it. Racerlite and Stake behind him finally stabilize the lead. Dev also managing to break away from Xtrem to secure 5th position. Xtrem in 6th, Miracle falling back to 7th, and Spider only in 10th place as he makes a severe mistake. He's dropping down the ranks like a fly.
Oh, just behind the Zernoob now, indeed.
Severe mistake, and Devil, who made a big mistake in front, now in 10th place, but still, he's not making up any time, which is integral. And as we are joined, I think, by Hugo in chat, yes, unfortunately.
Yeah.
The internet causing him to drop away, always a shame, but we've seen a lot of internet issues in BFNL, some of them caused by the game and some of them by the players themselves, so nothing to be surprised by. Pomine again to 7/10 of a second. Devil sets the fastest overall lap in a 43.39. Well, actually, with 5 of the 12 fastest laps, so the comeback has been well and truly happening, but he made a very big mistake early on, so he is on the comeback trail and he doesn't have a whole lot of time left to gain a lot of positions. I think he also made a very significant mistake now. He's actually dropping Caster Curse to Oblivion. He falls back all the way down to, I believe, 14th or 15th place. Devil, despite having 5 of the 12 fastest laps, nowhere to be found. And it's not the first time this evening it's happened either. Endurance does not favor the fast, it favors the consistent. Stake has exemplified that.
And Dopa, with Lucky Shot having to release quite hardly, I think. Dopa super close now.
Only 2/10 of a second now, so Dopa finally looking to retake the first place, which he feels he deserves. Look to continue the unbroken streak of first place finishes, and obviously continue an unbroken streak of first place finishes in every BFNL week that hasn't been by Athlon.
Very true.
Seal his complete and utter dominance over NASCAR as it stands, but Lucky Shot now increasing the pace slightly, I think that might have been a bit of a better line than Dopamine's. To see, however, if it will translate into more pace in his final turns of lap number 14, a 20-lap race. They had, into the beginning of lap 15, 6 laps to go.
Oh, Dopa!
The unlucky shot is releasing a Dopamine retake.
There we go!
This is the end of it all. Nez gets lapped. Dopamine retakes the lead.
It will...
Lucky shot lasted for 14 laps, but it was out to be, but now Dopamine makes a mistake and Lucky Shot regains the lead. Ooh, it's going to be so close between them. Now nothing separating these two players.
Wow. All right, it's a nice fight going on for first place with Lucky
third
and Dopa.
Lucky, Racerlight and Stake are keeping it close, but they're not making up any time. They will not be a factor in this battle. Devil has dropped off, Spider has dropped off, Mew has dropped off. Some of the players with the fastest laps are not actually making anything. Nez, with the 11 fastest lap driven so far, is only in 17th place, dead last, if not for Hugo's connection issue.
Wow.
Ekstrem recovering to 6th place, Focus maintaining only 8th place. This time, consistency is not enough. You must have pace as well. Focus not managing perhaps to deliver the same pace as he was on the previous maps. His Lucky Shot now risking and releasing a lot. Dopamine has regained the 1st place, and he's looking to break away as well. Lucky Shot lasted for an incredibly respectable 16 laps almost. In the end, even with Mapper's advantage, Dopamine is just so good. He's unstoppable, he's incredibly consistent, and he will not ever let go, but Lucky Shot does. A small touch is gonna send him behind, and I fear this is the end of his hopes for first place.
I think so. Dopa now cruising away, and all of a sudden there is a pretty big gap.
Devil
there
again with the fastest lap. So now Devil again, I think he might almost have 6 of the top 12 fastest laps, but he's only in 13th place, 34 seconds behind the lead. Endurance does not favor the fast, it favors the consistent, and you cannot hope he had a good result by just having the fastest possible TA time. Spider now matches that fastest lap in a 43:36, and look at where he is, 12 seconds behind the lead in 10th place.
And they are far, far behind.
Consistency is king, and Dopamine is the king of consistency.
Yeah, no
one
mistake.
1 second
so.
Now ahead of Lucky Shot. Unfortunately, several releases lost him the lead of this race, which he has held for more than a majority. Should still be applauded for the performance. KWS retiring, either due to connection issues or because he was just going too goddamn slow. Never know. When Lucky Shot made a severe mistake, he's going to be dropping more positions. He has to respawn all the way at the start line.
Oh.
He's actually now below 10th place. And
he
retires.
Gives up. No.
From
first
place,
no.
Dead last.
Oh my god. What a retire. And what a jump and a landing there, and it is just done.
With the game.
Yeah.
Killed on his own map, and now the Hots duo gained the podium positions, 2nd and 3rd place. Now firmly under control, Ekstrem, who has driven 7 seconds behind and generally been quite quiet compared to the previous maps, inherits a very respectable 4th place. Yuki also retires. Not sure whether it is due to a severe mistake or something else, but we are losing players like flies.
Yeah, but only one more lap to go after this one. Lap 19 now, so almost done.
That one respawn would have costed Lucky more than 15 seconds.
Wow.
As a mapper, as Vamos Dikar mentions,
he's
regretting not putting a better checkpoint for himself to respawn on, as now it is also Racerlight and Stake trying to lap you.
Wow.
Embarrassing end to it all, and FKX players themselves, I think.
Oh, Racer!
Oh no, Racerlight!
Oh, what a full stop into some barrier there. And he will lose everything.
It's going to send him below 10 places. They enter the final lap. This was the worst time to make a mistake. You were consistent for 18 and a half laps. But it is 20, not 18. And Racerlight, where does he find himself after that sort of mistake? 7th place. That's 7th place with 4 retirements. That's something I think he'll be too proud of. And especially considering the position he was in an extra. Who I think hasn't really stood out in this particular race, has been very quiet compared to his performance level, is actually going to inherit 3rd place. And Stake was just smartly stuck to his pace and didn't care about what was happening ahead of him. Oh no, he makes a mistake. Is that enough for Ekstrem to overtake him? No, I think Ekstrem made a small mistake as well. It is actually Miracle who inherits 3rd place at the end as Dopamine reaches the finish line in the 14:40. Stake will finish despite his mistake in the respectable 2nd place.
Ekstrem
actually finishes in
Ekstrem in 4th.
2/10 of a second.
Oh, sniped.
2/10 of a second. Racerlight in 6th place. He snipes Belmont at the end by 2/100 of a second.
Oh my days. So we see a very interesting twist to what
Focus
seemed
again,
like
top five.
Yeah, he's
five
in fifth place again.
Nothing. Five from nothing.
Absolutely insane. And Devil here in 12th place, Mew 13th, with indeed four people that gave up. Ay ay ay. What
to
a massacre
fair, like,
in the end.
What a massacre. Four players do not even finish.
Holy
Two
moly.
Players at least get lapped. Devil is 34 seconds behind, and it feels that at some point, yeah, a lot of player echoing sentiments that the bugs are really, really killing them.
All right.
It's kind of hard to think, because Lucky Shot, realistically, he was leading for 15 laps and he does not even finish.
Whew. Yeah, that was almost heartbreaking to see. I have to say.
It is heartbreaking to see, and it is also heartbreaking from a perspective of, how should I even say this? Feels like a lot of players in multiple rounds of BFNL have been pushed into not caring or even not competing because bugs have actually completely ruined the fun of the tournament for them.
Yeah. Yeah, very true. We saw it in multiple instances.
Spider is leaving us after four maps.
Wow.
Pink says bye-bye all.
That would be a shame. Yeah.
There he has still been, one map left.
Yeah, he was not really playing well on the first map, but of course we have discussed that. But after that, I think Spider has been doing pretty well, especially on map 2 and 3. So that would be a shame if he is gone. Let's see what happens now.
So this is the fifth map. It is Untrained Liquid Ritual by Vamos de Car, and obviously, you mention that name, you think to yourself, no, this is about to be a good map, and there should be no issues with it whatsoever. Because, you know, really, Vamos de Car is one of the greatest names of NASCAR mapping ever, if not the outright greatest, and
probably.
You kind of think to yourself that if there is someone that is capable of delivering a competitive map on TMNF of all games, it could be him. And from what I'm seeing, the confidence is absolutely not misplaced. So Mew will be leaving us, I feel, and he's not pleased at all with how entrances went. I think players, they are making their way. Oh my god.
Wow.
As I say, they're making their way. Two of them make the same exact mistake.
Yeah.
So a good map, from my view, should be drivable in endurance, indeed. Yeah. And it is, I think, exactly what you would expect when you see that name on the upper table. You kind of smile to yourself and you say, you know, this is going to be good.
Very nice, Ender, indeed. Do we know how many laps we got here? Would be nice to know.
I'm not sure if anyone reported it, but in any case, 15 laps.
15.
Laps.
Okay, great. All right.
So for some reason, it puts me out of me into player mode so I could actually see the 15 lap marker.
Ah, nice.
And
and there we go.
To then the final map of Endurance for this one, not the final map of BFNL, to be sure. There is still one more group of Endurance players, but all the best players play tonight, it seems. So this may be the last high division gameplay that you will see the BFNL indeed, and feel like maybe at the end of it all, with some players even leaving, with a lot of players voicing their frustration, I think that for a lot of people, BFNL is going to be an incredibly fun tournament that ends on a somewhat bitter note, but more on that obviously in the ending, as Ekstrem is going to have a bitter note on lap one, as he's already touched the wall and he's out of it all. Into then, beginning of lap number 2 of 15, and it is Devil, Spider, and Yuki occupying the top three positions. Dopamine settling for fourth, Nez in fifth, Stake in sixth, Razorlight in solitary 11th place. Being said, though, the leads are still quite, you know, it's still quite competitive, so a lot of players still with the chance to make a prolonged comeback as Spider. Oh my lord, what was that?
That was ugly, but he just stays alive.
An ugly bug almost removes him immediately from the map, and he will indeed be forced to sacrifice multiple positions. It's Devil and Yuki, the only ones that seem to be daring, along with Dopamine, to take this map at full speed. And oh, Dopamine, that's a big risk. A risk which will cost him, as the Ramstein actually eroded some of his speed, but he is still alive and breathing, although alive and breathing in fourth place as Spider retakes third. And the fastest lap is set by Yuki of all people.
Alright.
44.79. Budala is out and disconnects. He's done for the evening.
Oh, Yuki!
Well for himself, and Yuki
full
is gone.
Stop. Oh, and he stops driving as well.
Lupug sends Bug. Him.
Yeah, he is. I think he's done. Oh my days! So he goes
will not
from...
be continuing, and he disconnects. We are two there players short. Actually, three players short because Mew quit even earlier.
Yeah.
And
all right.
It is going to be a very lonely final map. The Liquid Ritual seems to be one of departures.
Devil.
Devil departs this mortal plane.
That seems to be a very tricky chicane there. Multiple crashes there we have seen already.
It is quite tricky, and it is now Spider that inherits the fastest lap and the lead of the race. Looking perhaps to finally seal the lead as he has 2 second place finishes, I believe.
Yeah.
Or at least 2 podium finishes, which is going to be quite good on his overall standings. Focus in third place now, but the second and a half behind. He won't be competing for the lead, safe to say that much.
All right.
5 maps for entrance is a bit too much, as I've almost mentioned in chat. Actually, I tend to agree. Endurance events are generally played over 4 maps, which last about 10 to 12 minutes, and this is 5 maps that last 12 or more minutes. So at this point,
yeah,
your concentration is quite low.
Yeah.
And not that the maps were particularly easy either. The flat map might have been easy, but first map, and then the final one as well, you know. I do think it has been incredibly demanding. The whole BFNL has been very demanding on players. We've had matches that lasted upwards of 2 hours. If they've been particularly close, because they are played by the rules of a team game and not cup mode, right?
Yeah.
On the other hand, it is this mode which gives BFNL
Spider.
Its charm, which Spider is not particularly enjoying right now as he drops off. Pomine inherits the lead. 5 wins in as many maps. It's been a very boring evening out in front for Dopamine. Well, not boring. I'm sure he does enjoy winning, but
yeah.
It has been very boring with a lack of competition, as his competition invariably either crashes or drives safely behind. Speaking of safe drivers, the safe drivers are taking the lead here, as Focus and Stake, two very safe and consistent drivers, are now inheriting second and third place of the race.
Well
done. Remarkably well for themselves and securing some crucial last-minute points when so many players are dropping away. Razorlight now sets day 2, third fastest lap. Bellman
out.
Goes out.
All right, so another down on this map. And we are with 16 left, I think, or is that 15?
Razorlight himself, like, despite having some of the fastest laps, look at where he is on this map, 13th. And it's not even... it's not the only map that he's had this happen, so Razorlight would have been of an underwhelming evening for somebody that we traditionally consider to be an endurance master.
Yeah.
However, should be said that he has played very well throughout this cup. The Division 1 was much stronger than before, so it is to be expected that Razorlight will no longer dominate it. Like in the last season of BFNL, Stake inherits Razorlight, just
what
as I mentioned. It's speaking of dominance, top one time. Lucky Shot is now driving in reverse.
Yeah, he is... I think out of it, Yuki as well. Super
Yuki
far behind. So
the display is just not showing. Yuki is disconnected from the server already.
Ah,
Lucky Shot finally respawns, but he is effectively out. We only have about 13 players actively driving.
All
right. I suppose is useful for people like Razorlight, as they will boost their position significantly despite early mistakes. And Razorlight, just as I speak of the devil, he breaks out insane pace. Stake in second place, but he's not even attempting to match Dopamine, and he doesn't need to. That's been the entire strategy this Primetime Cup. His 2 second place finishes were off the back of being more consistent than anyone else in Div 1.
He's doing very well, shows it tonight again.
Focus in third place ahead of Spider, and maintaining the gap to Stake as well, so Focus is going to be loving life. He must have gained
good.
A lot of points tonight, because this isn't the first time he's finishing at a top 5. Of course, does bear saying that, oh no, he now takes second place. He's doing so well for himself, as people are finally starting to pick up on the fact that Lucky is driving in reverse, which I don't think is really nice. If people are driving with cars on, you're
just that would not be great.
Attracting them necessarily. It would be nice to retire. A fair thing, you know? But obviously, to be, as we are approaching now, we are now in lap number 9 of 15. Nez
right.
Setting a very respectable time. Not one of the 12 fastest, but a personal best for himself as Ekstrem sets an incredibly fast 81 by 2/10 of a second, almost 3 full-tenths of a second. That was one of the fastest laps, you know, possibly imaginable. But where is Ekstrem anyway?
This is really weird. Yeah, I do
Ekstrem
not see him anymore.
Place. He's in 11th place.
Oh, it doesn't show on the left.
Popman now proves, yeah, because leaderboard is a bit buggy. And now the top times are being beaten regularly. Spider 44-34, Doppelmate in a 44-12, Ekstrom in a 44-11. So the times are going down, but unfortunately, a lot of players are not reaping the benefits of their hard work. Spider now, however, trying to take that third and second place. His Lucky Shot keeps driving in reverse. Man, retire already.
He might be playing with cars on.
That's not very nice. As we continue, none of the players seem to be significantly bothered by it. We are approaching the end of lap 10. That's going to be the two thirds mark.
Spider
caps it off in style. Oh no, he touches the wall.
Oh no. So close to overtake two people in one go there.
Thanks to those two mistakes, it is Focus that now inherits a significant advantage in second place, looking to cap off an incredible endurance performance and a very good BFNL, dare I say personally, with an incredibly strong solo performance as Spider is now honking gratuitously at stake and manages to put the overtake in, stake demoting from the podium position, but he is very safe in fourth place, should not be dropping it for the remaining few laps that we have of endurance.
All
Devil
right.
is being lapped. What is going on?
Super far behind indeed. I think last
had
place...
a few real stinkers, especially on the untrained maps. Yeah. He mentioned it himself, however, that untrained endurance is definitely not something he's capable of doing at a strong level, and that's fair. It is one of the greatest challenges. I don't think we've ever had to drive endurance untrained.
I don't think that has ever been practiced. And
the way I think that we've kind of proven that it's not a great idea today.
Yeah, very true. As we see overtake Focus here, by the way.
I really do not think that it is very fair to the players to drive untrained endurance. And five maps as well with standard endurance distance. So they're driving more than usual. They're driving untrained, which I'm really not seeing the point of. It has also undermined competitiveness as it has really just been the Dopamine show for five maps long. It really begs the question, like, what's the point of it all? As Focus kind of shows what the point of it all is, he's proving himself. He actually overtakes Spider heading
fighting
into lap
for
14.
Second.
Only two laps remaining for this incredible fight for second place.
Wow.
Mistake,
very nice.
Not that far behind, but I don't think he's able to do anything unless they make a mistake up front. Again, just driving safely, which is what he should be doing. As now Spider is kicking up the pace, trying to overtake Focus, but Focus is proving a hard nut to crack. He's not dropping his pace even a little bit. He actually takes a better corner than Spider, but the line might now disfavor him a bit. No, it doesn't. Focus increases his lead. Clutch when it matters the most. However, managed to retain that clutch performance all the way to the end. Spider now drastically increases his pace and is now looking to complete the overtake, and he does. To the final corner,
well
heading into lap 15. Luxy is also about to be lapped by more than a single player. Final lap of the race. Focus drives his own personal best, but Spider outclasses it by multiple tenths of a second. The pace difference is a bit too much.
Well, let's see if Focus can keep it up here. Still very nice performance in the top three. Podium finish for him.
I think he's safing. I think he's safing at this point. Like, there is no need to risk. Take the third place. It is realistically the best you can ask for. Don't try to do anything stupid at the last moment to compete, especially not when so many free points have been given to you by other players quitting. Just finish the match. Nez gets lapped. Luxy barely avoids getting lapped in what was, in hindsight, a shambolic map 5. However, the front has kept it enjoyable. Dopamine. Is it 20 laps?
No, I think 15.
Must have.
We said, right?
Oh, so no. We just are on lap 15. Sorry.
Exactly. Into the last lap right now.
Being said, however, nothing much is changing as Spider, unfortunately. The pace advantage is just too much for Focus to overcome. It doesn't really matter. Third place, really more than respectable enough.
Yeah.
As Nez and other players have just started hunting, because honestly, untrained endurance is... Untrained endurance with a 1 minute warm-up. I don't think I've seen anything like it in my life.
Oh, that is bald. Really?
And it was free untrained maps to two trained maps.
Yeah.
Dopamine finishes
finish
it off in 11-17, five wins in as many maps. Spider second, Focus third, Stake fifth, Dev with a very respectable fifth place, Miraku finishes sixth, Razorlight is going to come home in an eighth behind Hugo in a very respectable seventh place, Devil capping off. But it was honestly an underwhelming run.
Yeah.
He's gonna basically be dead last. Ekstrem with the fastest overall lap is going to have to settle for 8th places. I think Raceolite might have even made a last minute mistake, and Ekstrem should be able to snipe him for 8th place. That he does, actually, Raceolite nowhere to be seen. He actually makes a severe mistake, only finishes 10th.
Yeah.
Mr. Noob with the 9th. Frankly, this was just not very fun to watch outside of the top 3. Multiple players straight up disconnecting, voicing their frustrations. Lucky Start deciding, yeah, let's just go drive in reverse while other people are trying to play the map, maybe with cars on, loot bugs, all the other things. And while I think that the map is very well made, I think at this point, this is a sort of weird way to cap off that this game is no longer competitively capable.
Yeah, very true.